As the summer winds down, Mater Dei Parish again welcomes our visitors to the Northeast Kingdom this weekend. We are glad that you have joined us. We hope you have a relaxing vacation and a safe trip back to your home. Please feel free to call the parish office if we can assist you in any way. St. Mary's 4 p.m. daily mass will resume on Tuesday, September 1st. We respectfully ask that everyone follow Bishop Coyne's guidance about wearing masks at mass and all church functions. Thank you for all you do to keep our parish family safe. Today's mass is offered for the repose of the soul of Tony Leighton.
Lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. You duped me, O Lord, and I let myself be duped. You were too strong for me, and you triumphed. All the day I am an object of laughter. Everyone mocks me. Whenever I speak, I must cry out. Violence and outrage is my message. The word of the Lord has brought me derision and reproach all the day. I say to myself, I will not mention him. I will speak in his name no more. But then it becomes like fire burning in my heart, imprisoned in my bones. I grow weary holding it in. I cannot endure it. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. Jesus began to show his disciples that he must go to Jerusalem and suffer greatly from the elders, the chief priests, and the scribes, and be killed, and on the third day be raised. Then Peter took Jesus aside and began to rebuke him. God forbid, Lord, no such thing shall ever happen to you. He turned and said to Peter, Get behind me, Satan. You are an obstacle to me. You are thinking not as God does, but as human beings do. Then Jesus said to his disciples, Whoever wishes to come after me must deny himself, take up his cross, and follow me. For whoever wishes to save his life will lose it, but whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. What profit would there be for one to gain the whole world and forfeit his life? Or what can one give in exchange for his life? For the Son of Man will come with his angels in his Father's glory, and then he will repay all according to his conduct. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
As Catholics, we have a custom of beginning our prayers with the sign of the cross. We end our prayers with the sign of the cross, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. And we begin the Mass that way, too, don't we? We end the Mass with a sign of the cross, a blessing for everyone before they leave to go back to their homes. There's a story about a couple of men who worked together, and they would ride the same bus every day. But on those shuttle buses, you know, like RCTA, every day they take that same bus. One was Catholic and the other one was Protestant. And the Catholic fellow kept on trying in various ways to get his friend, Protestant friend, to become a Catholic. He told him how important it was that we profess our faith in the Trinity by making the sign of the cross. So he taught him about make the sign of the cross. So anyway, one morning, it was a cold winter morning, and the roads were kind of slushy, and the bus got into a skid. They tipped over, the bus flipped over on the side. And when the bus landed, the Catholic fellow turned to his friend, the Protestant friend, and said, Are you okay? And the fellow said, Oh yeah, I'm okay. And the Catholic said, Well, I see that you made the sign of the cross right after stepped over. And the Protestant fellow said, No, I wasn't making the sign of the cross. I was just checking my forehead for the bump that I felt from the accident. And he said, I was checking my shoulders just because of the pain that I felt there. He said, I felt down here to my pocket to make sure you hadn't stolen my wallet. So that was the sign of the cross that the Protestant fellow made. In today's Gospel, Jesus speaks to us not about the sign of the cross, but rather taking up our crosses. If we want to come after him, if we want to be his followers, Jesus says we have to take up our crosses. Take up our crosses to follow him. And there's lots of ways that we do that. And some ways are bigger than others. Some ways are more sacrificial, you might say, than others. Think, for example, during this COVID-19 virus that we have. Big sacrifice, I think, for people that live in nursing homes, people who live in nursing homes, people who live in, rest homes, like our good friend Father Dabner, who used to be here as your pastor. They can't go out. They can't have visitors close to them. They can have visitors, they say, 6 feet away, but it's more like 12 feet away. We even have to wear a mask outside to visit our relatives and our friends who are in nursing homes. Big sacrifice for those people. sacrifices for some, and sometimes taking up our crosses in little ways too, daily. For example, making time for the morning and evening prayers. It's easier just to get up and start our day without even making a prayer, offering our day to God, ending our day with a little prayer, thanking God for the day, telling God, well, this wasn't such a great day, how about a little bit better tomorrow? You know, we do that. That's the way we make our prayers so our God is a loving God. It could be making time for the rosary. That could be part of our small cross, small sacrifice that we make. Try to recite the rosary at least once a day. It could be the routine things that we do, you know, every day. It gets to be boring sometimes. One of the wonderful things about being a priest is that not one day is the same as the other. And I know what it's like to work in a boring job. It's the same old stuff every day, SOS, same old stuff. I know what that's like because I worked at Woods years ago down here on Coventry Street. Same old thing every day. But that's part of our sacrifices, to take up our crosses and follow Jesus. Mothers, a Mother's Day never ends. They say, well, mothers do a lot of sacrifices in their lives, taking care of the little ones, sometimes taking care of their elderly parents. So there's lots of ways out there for us to take up our crosses and follow in the steps of Jesus. And, you know, it's something that sometimes when we do make sacrifices, big or small, we're sometimes going to be criticized, going to be ridiculed. For example, people who work in the Respect Life ministries, they're put down, they're ridiculed because they aren't with it. Today's world is supposed to be, you know, easy come, easy go, whatever you do is fine. There's nothing wrong with abortion today. Those are the, you know, that's gone by, those days are gone by. But that's not true. And so sometimes we're going to be criticized, we're going to be ridiculed, made fun of, because we stand up for what's right. That's taking up our crosses too, isn't it? In the first reading today, we heard about Jeremiah the prophet, and he knew he had to spread God's word. That was part of his call from God, to spread the word of God. But he knew that he was going to be meeting with derision and reproach from other people because he dared to speak out God's word. People ridiculed him and reproached him for that. But yet when he began thinking about not doing it, it says in the scripture today that he felt it was like a fire burning in his heart. He just couldn't stop doing God's work. He was willing, even before Jesus, he was willing to take up his cross and do the work of God in his life. We can be confident, though, no matter what we do by way of sacrifice, by way of taking up our crosses, that God sees, God knows those things that we do. Jesus tells us in today's gospel, the very last line of the gospel passage, that the Son of Man will come and will repay all according to his or her conduct. Whatever we do, God is seeing those things and he will repay us. You can be sure of that. Our efforts of taking up our crosses and bearing with them in good times and in bad, they won't go unnoticed. God sees and knows all things. And so whatever we do, we might say losing some of our We now profess our faith together by reciting the Creed. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate in the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our Savior was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will not end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We seek God's love and understanding of our human imperfections, just as Peter, in his human frailty, failed to understand Christ's mission on earth. Let us bring our prayers to God our Father, who has always been our help and our salvation.
For the members of the Holy Catholic Church, that the fire of the Holy Spirit may embolden us to give witness to God and serve others by following the example of Jesus as priests, deacons, single or married persons. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For the victims of the California wildfires and Hurricane Laura, that God will ease their suffering, give them strength, and help them find the resources they need to rebuild their homes, lives, and communities. Lord, in your mercy. For the repose of the souls of those in the Northeast Kingdom who died this past week, that the merciful love of Christ may cleanse and prepare them for eternal life with him, and their grieving families may find healing from their sorrow from Christ's loving presence in their lives and the strength and support of a caring community. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
For all who carry their own private crosses, known only to God and to themselves, that they may turn to God in their time of need and rely on his mercy, compassion, and healing power. Lord, in your mercy. For all of us gathered around the Eucharistic table in faith today, and for those who cannot be with us, that we may be given the grace to follow Christ and embrace our crosses, even when we experience opposition, hardship, or rejection. Lord, in your mercy. For the repose of the souls of Anthony Lakeview, for whom this Mass is offered, Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Loving Father of our Lord Jesus, help us to think more as you do and less as the frail human beings that we are. May the fire of your love burn strongly in our hearts as we make these prayers to you through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May this sacred offering, O Lord, confer on us always the blessing of salvation, that when it celebrates in mystery, it may accomplish in power, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin Mary. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with all the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Victim,
by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May you make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your God, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Christopher, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy to be under my roof, but only say the word.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you have already come, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Thank you.
Please keep this in mind as you consider your donation for this week. Thank you for your continued generosity to our parish. Bulletins are available as you leave the church today. Mater Dei's 6th annual parish picnic was a huge success. 150 meals were served in spite of the coronavirus. We sincerely thank Morris Bressard and the Knights of Columbus for all their hard work in organizing and catering the picnic. We are truly grateful for your service to our parish. And we wish everyone a safe and healthy weekend and a wonderful week.
Let us pray. Renewed by this bread from the heavenly table, we beseech you, Lord, that being the food of charity, it may confirm our hearts and stir us to serve you in our neighbors. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.